Welcome to our new topic, pedigree analysis. Pedigree analysis is a record of occurrence of a trait in several generations of a family. Okay, pedigree analysis is a record of occurrence of a trait. Occurrence of a trait in several generations of a family. That is known as pedigree analysis. Okay. It is not possible that to do perform process to analyze the inheritance patterns of traits in humans. Okay, so for this we have to study the family history of the organism or particular trait. Suppose a disease or a condition is occurring in a trait or a family, we can analyze easily through this pedigree analysis. So pedigree analysis based upon some characters, for example eye color, skin color, hair form, then hair color and other facial characteristics. Sometimes the genetic disorders are also using this pedigree analysis. Eye color means we know how the iris having color. Okay, some having the black color and some having the light shades. Okay, so that all these characters are inheriting from our parents to offspring. Hence, by using this pedigree analysis for the study of a specific traits of disorders or generations after generation, it is possible to trace the pattern of inheritance. We know that in our body, two types of chromosomes are present, autosomes and allosomes. So, in which chromosomes the trait is happening or trait is occurring, we can find out with the help of this pedigree analysis. So the importance of the pedigree analysis is it is useful for the genetic counselors to advise intending couples to about the possibility of having children with genetic defects like hemophilia, thalassemia, etc. Sometimes in a genetic history, there may be a chance for continuous abortion. Okay, or another chance for the occurrence of a type of genetic disease in the history. So the genetic counselors are using this pedigree chart to analyze which type of genetic trait they are carrying. Okay, and it's also helpful to study certain genetic trait and find out the possibility of absence or presence of trait that in homozygous or heterozygous condition. Okay, so these are the main aspects or importance of the pedigree analysis, mainly helping for the find out genetic disorders. Clear it is. So in pedigree analysis, there is some symbols to analyze the hereditary. Okay, so here the square means male and circle means female. Okay, the symbol square means male and circle means female. If both are shaded, square and the circle are shaded completely, that means they are affected. Affected means which trait we are analyzing these to have that type of a trait. Clear it is. Here the square is connected by the circle. Okay, so this means mating. If it is connected by two lines, that means consanguineous marriage, that means relatives. Okay, then male and female are connected and they are again connected or again branched. Okay, so this means these after mating, these are their offsprings. So this is first generation and this one is the second generation. Clear it is. In case of identical twins, represented like this. Okay, so here these two are female and for the non-identical twins they have no connected lines like this. Look here, they have a connected line. These two identical twins are connected, but here look, there have no any connections. Clear it is. So this is symbol for non-identical twins. So what is pedigree? The pedigree is the analysis. Pedigree analysis is the record of occurrence of a trait in several generations of a family. Okay, so these are the mainly pedigree analysis is used for analyzing genetic disorders and can be expressed this pedigree analysis by using different symbols. Okay, so here the completely shaded means they are affected. Sometimes they are partially shaded. Partially shaded means they are carriers of the disease. Carriers of the disease. Sometimes they are crossed. Suppose this male are crossed and female are crossed. Okay, so that means the parent, the partner, or the male or female get diseased. Clear it is. So first we are discussing autosomal dominant. Autosomal dominant. So here clear that the trait occurring in the autosomes and that trait is dominant. Dominant means both the female and the male have the tendency to acquire that trait. Clear? Autosomal dominant. It's clear that it's occurring in the autosomes. Okay, dominant means both the male and the female have the equal chance for getting this disease. So first condition is here mating occurs. Okay, male and here female. How many children they have? They have 6 children. So in this, both the male and the female get affected. Both the male and the female get affected. That means mother can give only the X chromosome. Clear it is. And the father can give Y chromosomes. Here the male get affected and the female get affected. It clearly indicates that the defective dominant trait they can be achieved from their mother. Clear? The defective dominant trait they can be achieved from their mother. Okay. So here the male is expressing the disease. His both children get affected. Okay. So if the mother giving X chromosome, here the father is giving the X chromosome, there may be no chance for expressing that character. Clear it is. It is autosomal dominant. Autosomal dominant means the character or the trait is expressed in the parent. So there may be a chance for getting this character to both the offsprings, female and the male. That is autosomal dominant. Next we are discussing autosomal recessive. Autosomal recessive means in case of parent the gene is recessive. When the gene is occurs in the dominant condition, only at that time the gene is expressing. That is autosomal recessive. Father have the chromosomes X and Y. Okay, if father give that X chromosome to his daughter, the daughter get affected. Here the male doesn't get affected because the male get the X chromosome from the mother. Okay, so autosomal recessive means the character seen or the trait is seen in the autosomes and also the character is recessive. Clear? Okay, so what is the difference between autosomal dominant and autosomal recessive? Autosomal means that gene in the genes which are located on the non-sex chromosome. Okay, the genes which are located in the non-sex chromosome, that means an autosome. And dominant means single copy of the disease. If the parent, any of the parent having the single copy of the gene, that is enough to cause the disease or the trait. But in recessive condition, but in recessive disorder, the two copies of the mutation are needed to cause the disease. Two copies of the mutation are needed to cause the disease. Clear? So here the father having autosomal recessive trait. Okay. So if both parents having heterozygous trait, so for forming a female girl child, she needed two X chromosomes. One she get from her father and one she get from her mother. Okay, so in mother also the gene is seen in heterozygous condition. That's why the female shows autosomal recessive character. Clear it is. The most common type of autosomal recessive disorder type is cystic fibrosis and sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia means normal the shape of RBC is disc shape. Okay, so the function of RBC is to carry oxygen. But in sickle cell anemic patients, what will happen? The RBC get changed into sickle shape. So there may be a chance for transporting less amount of oxygen through this sickle shaped RBCs. Cystic fibrosis means we know that our respiratory tract are filled with mucus. Okay, so this mucus get hardened. So that is condition as cystic fibrosis. We will discuss these diseases in our genetic disorders category. Okay, just now I just tell the example for this autosomal recessive trait. Clear it is. So, what are the conditions or what are the causes for autosomal recessive disorder? Because there occur mutation. Mutation is the main reason for the autosomal recessive disease. Clear it is? Okay. Then the next example for this autosomal dominant is autosomal dominant. We discuss cystic fibrosis and sickle cell anemia. That is an example for the disease autosomal recessive. And the next disease autosomal dominant. For autosomal dominant, the examples are Huntington disease and Marfan syndrome. Okay, Huntington disease and Marfan syndrome. According to our NCERT textbook, we have to just study the autosomal recessive disorder and sex-linked inheritance, not to study autosomal dominant conditions. Clear it is. So in autosomal dominant condition, one gene is needed to cause the disease. But in autosomal recessive, the two genes are needed. Two genes are needed. In parents, the genes are situated in heterozygous condition. That is needed for causing the disease. Okay, next we are discussing sex-linked inheritance. Sex-linked inheritance, it is clear that the chromosomes is responsible. Which chromosome? Sex chromosomes are responsible for the trait or the disease. Clear it is. Okay, so which are the sex chromosomes? X chromosomes and the Y chromosome. X chromosomes and Y chromosomes are the sex chromosomes. X chromosomes and Y chromosomes. Male are heterozygous and the female are homozygous. So look in this picture, the blue color shaded portion, that is a normal male, and half shaded with red, which indicate affected one. Half shaded with red, which indicate affected one. So female have the chromosome XX. Okay, and male have the chromosome XY. Suppose if affected X chromosomes are enter into, affected X chromosomes are enter into the male, the male is expressing that disease and the female is just a carrier to the disease, because she get non-infected X chromosomes, non-infected X chromosome from her father. But the son get infected X chromosome from his mother. Clear? So this type of pattern is known as crisscross inheritance or zigzag pattern. Crisscross inheritance or zigzag pattern. What is this crisscross inheritance? Females are carrier and the males are expressing the disease. These type of inheritance are known as crisscross inheritance. Clear it is? Females are the carrier. Okay, half shaded means they are not expressing the disease. They are just carrier of the disease. fully shaded with red color means they exhibiting that disease. So this type of inheritance are known as crisscross inheritance or zigzag inheritance. Clear it is. So example for this crisscross inheritance and zigzag inheritance is hemophilia and color blindness. In genetic disease portion, we will discuss what is color blindness and what is hemophilia. So females are always carrier in the sex chromosomal inheritance, and male is exhibiting that type of character. Clear it is.